Very good evening all. Am I audible? Yeah. Chalo. So for the first time, I am with thermal subject. My first class was on like gate practice strategy, and the second class was on helical springs, and third class was on vapor pressure cavitation. And we are now today I'll discuss psychrometric terms and development of psychrometric chart if time permits. Many are requesting, please start class on ESC section also. Let me tell you very clearly. So whatever the subjects I'm covering, whether it is fluid mechanics, heat transfer, strength of metals, it will be covered. Oh, Chirag bhai, Chirag, very, very good evening. ESC section ke liye, today I got a minimum of 70 messages. Please start on ESC platform. Okay, like till February I'll be on this, then I'll be both on, like maybe like in 3-4 days I'll let you know, I'll give you clarity. Okay, I'll be available both on gate and ESC platform. But whatever the subjects I cover, it will be purely from all examinations point of view. It's not just gate or it's not just ESC. Yeah, Congo for Hyderabad best academy. Thank you, Chirag bhai. Came got the best institute award recently. Are yaar kitne log pooch rahe yaar, please start ESC online. Suno, so I am starting fluid mechanics on 23rd of October. It will be a full fledged detailed in-depth analysis class. All areas will be covered, not just gate. It will be gate, ESC first. I'll cover all subjects, I mean all concepts. Chalo. Okay, now let me start the session. My fluid mechanics session is coming on 23rd of October, and it will be a full-fledged detailed class daily from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. And definitely we'll be enjoying a lot. Are Baba, Mehboob Ali bhai, namaste. Chalo, let us not waste time anymore. Sabko hai, pranam, good evening. Chalo, now let's start. See, today's class is on psychrometry. Yes. You know, psychrometry is, we have to condition air. To condition air, we need to know properties of air. If I increase the temperature, what happens? If I increase the humidity, what happens? Therefore, there is a need for us to know properties of air. So before we enter air conditioning, we should go to one department, that is psychrometry department. It is the branch which deals with the study of properties of, it deals with study of properties of air. Now, as you are conditioning air, you need to know the properties of air. Now, understand carefully. Let us take air. What do we have in air? Let's try to understand. Basically, we have nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, argon, and small amount of course, other gases. Please observe here, this part and small amounts of other inert gases, of course, argon is also inert. We also have water vapor. Namaste, sabko namaste. Ab come back. We also have water vapor. Simply when I say air, it is nothing but which comprises of nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, argon, and water vapor. Please mind you, there is dust, there are dust particles also. So I'm removing, imagining like I remove all dust particles. Now we have only these like nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, argon, and water vapor. Right. Okay. If you take these parts, relatively they are fixed. And my dear students, this is very, very small. So I remove this. Predominantly we have nitrogen and oxygen. Predominantly we have nitrogen and oxygen. So if you take on mass basis, in 100 kg, 77 is nitrogen, 23 is oxygen. Actually, there is a small variation, but in a small amount of other gases, we are removing, neglecting, in fact. So we have nitrogen and oxygen, basically. And this part, we call it as dry part or dry air. This is water vapor, is the moisture content in air. It is a variable part. The water vapor which is present in air can vary from place to place. If you go to coastal areas, the amount of water vapor present in air is different. So, agar aap coastal areas ko jayenge, to water vapor ka content kuch alag hai. Or normal areas, water vapor ka content kuch alag hai. Lekin, agar aap dry part lenge, relatively, what do you mean by relatively? Agar aap certain dry part le lenge, us dry part mein nitrogen, carbon dioxide, that is fixed. That's why hum is dry air ko bolenge fixed part. We call it as fixed part. So, what do we have in fixed part? So, fixed part mein nitrogen, oxygen, argon, carbon dioxide and some other gases. Ye jo hai na, relatively unka part fix hota hai. Please kuch comments, comments kuch mat likhna, aram se sunte jana. Aapko jo aata hai, mind mein rakh lena. Right. Water vapor is a variable part. So my dear students, agar aap air dekhenge, if you see, agar aap air lenge, whenever I say air, it is actually moist air. So it is a two component system. I repeat, moist air ya fir simply air, it is a two component system. To ye do kya kya components hai? We have dry air. To dry air mein kya kya hai? Oxygen, nitrogen, thoda sa chote chote, in small quantities, other gases I'm neglecting. So now we have water vapor. So this is, I write now onwards, water vapor WV, or dry air ko hum DA likhenge. Very good. Now, so it is two component system, that is dry air and water vapor. And one more thing I'm telling you, when I'm using Hindi, first I teach in English, then I use Hindi. Don't worry. Look at now. Are Surendra Verma, audio is not coming. So everyone says audio is, everyone is audible and there must be some problem with you. Chalo, koi baat nahi. Now, what is psychrometry? It is the branch of science which deals with the study of properties of moisture. Matlab, air ko condition karne se pehle, before conditioning air, you need to study properties of air. So isile first I go to psychrometry department, then I go to air conditioning. So what is psychrometry? It is a branch of science which deals with the study of properties of moist air. Now, so air is a two component system. Two component kya kya hai? Dry air and water vapor. Chalo. Ab hum dekhte hai, ek second. Let us take some air. this I write it as moist air. Whenever I use the word air, it is moist air. ध्यान से सुनो, जब भी मैं एयर का वर्ड इस्तेमाल करता हूं, इसका मतलब मॉइस्ट एयर है, उसमें वाटर वेपर है. अगर मैं ड्राई एयर बोल रहा हूं तो एक्सक्लूसिवली आई यूज ड्राई एयर, जिसमें वाटर वेपर नहीं है. ड्राई एयर फिक्स्ड पार्ट होता है. आई टेल यू हाउ. ओके, नाउ मान लो लेट द टोटल वॉल्यूम ऑफ दिस, ए टोटल वॉल्यूम बी वी. ध्यान से सुनना, इस पूरे वॉल्यूम में, इन दिस कंप्लीट वॉल्यूम, vapor, water vapor is occupying and dry air is also spread. Matlab, if sare volume mein there is water vapor, there is dry air also. So now I say the total volume is not only the volume of A. A stands for dry air and it is also equal to volume of vapor. I repeat. Ye jo water vapor hai, this water vapor, I have taken a system, so my water vapor is occupying this complete volume. Similarly, my dry air is also occupying this complete volume. So volume of dry air is equal to volume of water vapor is equal to volume of the system. Very good. फिर से बता रहा हूँ, सुनो, जो हम एक सिस्टम को लिए, मेरे हाथों की तरफ देख रहा हूँ, जब हम एक सिस्टम लिए, उस सिस्टम में वेपर पूरा वॉल्यूम ऑक्यूपाई कर रहा है, ड्रायर पूरा वॉल्यूम ऑक्यूपाई कर रहा है. मतलब ऐसा नहीं कि एट सम पार्ट्स देयर इज ओनली वेपर, सम पार्ट्स देयर इज ड्रायर. इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट. इट इज स्प्रेड थ्रू आउट. सो इन माय वॉल्यूम वेपर इज स्प्रेड, इन माय वॉल्यूम ड्रायर इज स्प्रेड. सो वॉल्यूम ऑफ वेपर इज इक्वल टू वॉल्यूम ऑफ ड्रायर इज इक्वल टू टोटल वॉल्यूम ऑफ द मिक्सचर. नाउ माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट द टेंपरेचर ऑफ दिस बी टी, the dry air and water vapor, they are in equilibrium. Iska matlab dry air ka temperature aur water vapor ka temperature kya hai, same hai. So therefore now I write it as TA is equal to TV, where TA stands for dry air, V stands for vapor. Matlab agar aap mere paas air hai to aap aisa haath स्प्रेड करना, मुंह करना, तो हर जगह आपको एक ही टेम्परेचर महसूस होता है. मतलब वेपर हो या ड्राइयर हो, सेम टेम्परेचर है. Now, let us assume that the total pressure of the system be P. Aap to jante hai, my air is existing at atmospheric pressure. So I write it as P total, that is total atmospheric pressure. But isme there are two parts. One is dry air and one is water vapor. One is dry air and one is water vapor. So therefore, let PV be the partial pressure of vapor, PA be the partial pressure of dry air. What do we mean by partial pressure? Let's understand this carefully. My dear students, let us take, this is the moist air. This is moist air. So in this moist air, there is water vapor. And the total pressure of the system is PT. Ab aisa karo aap, us system mein jo dry air hai, us dry air ko sara hata dena. Remove all dry air. Now we have only water vapor. Lekin condition kya hai? Same temperature, same volume. To us same volume mein jo dry air tha usko hum nikal diye. To ab bacha kya hai? Now only what is left? Only when water vapor is removed, or when let us say dry air is removed. When you remove dry air, only vapor is left. So whatever the pressure the vapor is exerting, whatever the pressure the vapor is exerting in the same volume and at the same temperature, jab aap pura nikal diye to keval vapor hai. To jo vapor pressure exert kar raha hai same volume, isme jo dry air tha usko hata di to keval vapor hai. To whatever the vapor is exerting, it is known as partial pressure of vapor. Similarly, agar aap dry this vapor ko hata denge to keval kya bachega? Keval kya bachega? If you remove, we have only dry air. So in the same volume and at the same temperature, whatever the pressure the dry air is exerting, it is known as partial pressure of dry air. So according to Dalton's law of partial pressure, the total pressure is given by partial pressure of dry air and partial pressure of vapor. I repeat. So agar aapko total atmospheric pressure chahiye, it is the sum of dry air and partial pressure of dry air and partial pressure of vapor ka summation hota hai. So matlab jo air mein water vapor hai aur dry air hai, to dry air ka partial pressure aur water vapor ka partial pressure dono ko add karenge to aapko total atmospheric pressure aata hai. It is roughly about 1.013 bar. Excellent. Now, observe, my dear students. Now I'll go to the first psychrometric term, that is humidity ratio. Humidity ratio. And it is also known as specific humidity. Humidity ratio or specific humidity, and it is designated with omega. And sometimes it is also known as absolute humidity. I repeat, humidity ratio or specific humidity. My dear students, all of you, are you following? All of you, are you following? Yes, very good, very good, very good. Stop, 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 I said. Yeah, are you following? Thumbs up lagao. Don't write why yes, time waste mat karna, just thumbs up. Okay, right, very good. Now, have a look at this. This is the moist air. Let the volume of this be V. Abhi to aapko bata hai. My water vapor and my dry air, both are spread throughout the volume. So I write this as volume of vapor, which is also equal to volume of dry air. Just now you saw, let the temperature be T. So temperature of vapor is equal to temperature of dry air. Both are existing in what? Equilibrium. Both are existing in what? Equilibrium. Ab sunna. Let the total pressure be P. So now, is mix, we have a moist air. So in that we have mass of vapor, we have mass of dry air. Excellent. Now let us see what specific humidity is. My dear students, it is defined as the ratio of mass of vapor to the mass of, Abhay Singh, you said both are in equilibrium. What does it mean? Matlab dry air ka or water vapor ka donon ka temperature same hai. That is known as equilibrium. So now omega is defined as mass of vapor to the mass of dry air. Now the question comes, my dear students, agar aap ye total liye, to total mass kitna hoga? Ma plus Mb. Dhyan se suno. Omega jab hum define kar rahe hai, to some of you may be getting doubt. It is Mv by Ma plus Mb. Aisa doubt aa sakta hai. Sir, total mass mein kitna vapor hai, usko hum humidity bolte hai. So actually, my dear students, it is not. Now let us say this is not. The reason is, dhyan se suno. Please listen carefully. Let us take our cooling coil. This is a cooling coil. This is a, listen, don't comment, just listen. This is a cooling coil. Ab air andar aa raha hai. Jab air aa raha hai, it is coming with dry air. It has dry air, it has water vapor. Dhyan se suna. Maan lo air andar aa raha hai. Us air mein 1000 gram dry air le lena aur 10 gram water vapor le lena. I repeat, there is air. Let the mass of dry air be 1000 gram. And let the mass of vapor be, chalo, 20 gram hai. Dhyan se suno. Ye maan lo ye bahut cool coil hai. Bahut cool, bahut low temperature hai. Jab air iske contact mein aayega, thoda water vapor condense ho jayega. Jab condense ho jayega, now, the air is leaving. Dhyan se suno. Dry air is not changing. 1000 gram agar aa raha hai, to 1000 gram, maan lo 1 second mein 1000 gram bahar jayega. Maan lo ye 8 gram gaya, condense ho gaya. To kitna vapor enter hua tha? 20. Kitna gaya? 8 gram. To bacha kitna? 12 gram. Iska matlab kaun sa fix hai, kaun sa variable hai? Dry air is a fixed part. Water vapor is a variable part. Excellent. So, dhyan se suno. Agar hum omega ko, dekho, Mb by Ma, ye kaun sa part hoga? What is this part, my dear students? This part is a fixed part. This is a fixed part. Excellent. So, agar denominator mein fixed part karenge, to numerator badega. If numerator is increasing, then omega is increasing. If numerator is decreasing, omega is decreasing. So I can easily understand, I can easily feel the variation of vapor if I fix it, the denominator. That's why all calculations in psychrometry or air conditioning are based on dry air part. I repeat, dry air part, which is a fixed part. इसीलिए कभी भी याद रखना, air conditioning calculation में जो fixed part होता है, which is a dry air. So therefore we take with dry air. So omega is defined as, my dear students, omega is defined as the ratio of mass of vapor to the mass of dry air. Excellent. Now the question is, how do I calculate mass of vapor and mass of dry air? Okay, now observe here. Dhyan se suno, my dear students. There is mass of vapor, there is mass of dry air. Agar aap dekhenge, dry air you can treat it as ideal gas. Already dry air mein kya kya hai, it's a mixture of gases like oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, so it, you can treat it as ideal gas. But what about water vapor? Can we treat it as ideal gas? Excellent, my dear students, excellent. A gas can be treated as an ideal gas only at low pressures. Agar aap air ko dekhenge, the atmospheric pressure is, the total atmospheric pressure is around 101.3 kilopascal. So I told you very clearly, it is nothing but partial pressure of dry air, partial pressure of vapor. Generally iske value aisa nahi ki fixed nahi, generally maan lo ye 98-99 hota hai, to bacha kitna, around 3 roughly, matlab not fixed ye. So what is the pressure of vapor? Bahut kam hai. So water vapor pressure is very low. As the water vapor pressure is very low, the water vapor in air can also be treated as what? Ideal gas. So now it is a two component system, that is dry air, which is nitrogen, oxygen, and this is water vapor. Both can be treated as ideal gases, because the what the problem is water vapor. Water vapor ko kya hum ideal gas treat karenge? Generally, what do you mean by water vapor? It is close to its liquid state. Jab wo liquid state ke liye isse close rehta hai, to kaisa hum ideal gas treat karenge? Lekin luckily the partial pressure of vapor is very low. Agar low pressure hai, to ideal gas ki tarah hum treat kar sakte. There is no problem at all. So now the mixture can be treated as ideal gas. It is a mixture of ideal gas. Excellent. Now have a look at this. So ab dekhte hain, let the partial pressure of vapor be PV, let the partial pressure of dry air be what? PA. And aapko bataya tha complete volume of vapor, volume of dry air, let it be V, and temperature of vapor is equal to temperature of dry air is equal to T. Kyunki dry air or water vapor ek hi temperature pe exist ho raha hai, aur volume of the vapor, volume of dry air, both are occupying same volume. Dekho, now let me apply ideal gas equation for what? Let me apply ideal gas equation for what? Dry air part. So you know PV is equal to MRT. It is an ideal gas. When I teach thermodynamics, I'll tell you when to treat a gas as ideal gas. What is real gas? What is perfect gas? What is semi-perfect gas? What is the difference? All these I'll be explaining in detail. Now this is my equation. So ab main kisko apply kar raha hu? Water vapor ko. Chalo, can we treat water vapor as an ideal gas? Anyone? Anyone? Can we treat water vapor as an ideal gas? Anyone? Can we treat water vapor as an ideal gas? Yes. Oh my God. Very good. But why? 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 Anyone? Why? Oh my. Low pressure. Excellent. Stop. 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 I said stop. Bas. Please. I'm very, very happy with your response. Please. Rukiye. Respect though. Please stop. Excellent. Lovely batch. Lovely batch of India. Not India. Lovely batch of whole world. So your batch is Namuna batch number 3. Already 1-2 ho gaye. Ab Namuna batch 3. Excellent. Now let me apply the equation. Chalo, Chirag Patel, ha 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 ha, kya maar dalunga. PV VV is equal to MV RV TV. PV, already you know volume of vapor is V, MV RV TV is T. Similarly, I'll apply for dry air. PA VA is equal to MA RA TA. But aap to jante hai, PA, volume of dry air is V, and MA RA TA is T. Can you tell me what is omega MV by MA, mass of vapor to the mass of dry air? So aisa karenge hum. Dekhiye ek baar. Dekho, let us take this as 1 and let us take this as 2. Isme MV hai, isme MA hai. So main kya kar raha hu? Equation 1 by equation 2. Let's see what do I get. 1, PVV by PAV. What is PVV? What is PVV? MV RVT by what is PAV MARAT. So dekho ek bar, V or V cancel, then T or T cancel, we have MV by MA is equal to PV by PA into ये इधर ले रहा है ना MV by MA तो इधर है तो you take these two to this side उल्टा हो जाएगा RA by RV. Now what is RA? It is the gas constant for dry air. What is RV? It is the gas constant for vapor. And you know, my dear students, R is equal to R bar by molecular weight, where R bar is universal gas constant. It is 8.314 kilojoule per kilomole Kelvin or 8.314 joule per mole per Kelvin. वो तो फिक्स रहेगा. यूनिवर्सल का मतलब क्या है? हर एक गैस के लिए वो तो सेम, यूनिवर्सली कांस्टेंट. देयर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन आर आर बार. आर बार इज यूनिवर्सल गैस कांस्टेंट, सबके लिए सेम, और आर इज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक गैस कांस्टेंट. क्योंकि ध्यान से सुनो, हर एक गैस का मॉलिक्यूलर वेट अलग होता है. आर बार तो कांस्टेंट है तो आर अलग अलग होता है. नाउ आई राइट माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गैस कांस्टेंट फॉर एयर आर बार बाय एयर का मॉलिक्यूलर वेट होता है 29. Then gas constant for vapor. Vapor is nothing but water ka vapor. Water molecular weight is 18. So therefore, it will be R bar by molecular weight is 18. Now let us substitute here. What is MV by MA? MV by MA is omega. Omega is equal to PV by PA into RA by RV. What is RA? R bar by 29 divided by RA by RV. RA is R bar by 29, RV is R bar by 18. So now we have R bar gone, R bar gone. So this R bar is gone. So we have omega is equal to, omega is equal to, ye 18 denominator of denominator to numerator mein jayega. So 18 by 29 into PV by PA. So my yahi equation dusre slide mein le raha hu. 18 by 29 PV by PA. I'm taking the same in the other slide. 18 by omega is 18 by 29 PV by PA. Omega is equal to 18 by 29 PV by PA. Chalo. If you calculate omega, it will be 18 by 29 hoga 0.62 or 0.622 jo bhi hai, and PV by PA. अभी तो बताया माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टोटल प्रेशर इज इक्वल टू पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ एयर प्लस पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ वेपर. सो देयरफॉर इफ यू वांट पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ एयर, इट विल बी टोटल प्रेशर माइनस पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ वेपर. सो ओमेगा इज इक्वल टू 0.622 पीवी बाय पीए. व्हाट इज पीए? पीए पीए पी टोटल माइनस पीवी. तो अगर इसको हम इस पे ध्यान देंगे, लुक एट माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, If you concentrate on this equation, we have derived omega, that is specific humidity, humidity ratio or absolute humidity, as mass of vapor to the mass of dry air. So final equation is 0.622 PV by P total minus PA. So PV, aap bahut careful rehna. Is equation ko derive karne ke liye hamara assumption tha, water vapor and dry air both are treated as ideal gases. And my dear students, the error is ideal gas actually, are they behaving like ideal gas? Agar hum real gas treatment leke karenge, the error is just 0.2%. So we are safe. We are safe. So no issues at all. No issues at all. No issues at all. So this is my equation. Aap jante hai, PT is atmospheric pressure. It is more or less constant. The atmospheric pressure is almost constant. When it is almost constant, ओमेगा किस पे डिपेंड हो रहा है एक बार देखना. 0.622 कांस्टेंट, पी टोटल कांस्टेंट, सिर्फ यहां पे क्या है, पीवी है. सो ओमेगा इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ वेपर. ओमेगा इज अ फंक्शन ऑफ व्हाट? पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ वेपर. द इक्वेशन फॉर सी, नाउ लेट अस राइट द यूनिट फॉर ओमेगा. व्हाट इज ओमेगा? मास ऑफ वेपर टू द मास ऑफ ड्राई एयर. सो वेपर कैन बी एक्सप्रेस्ड एज केजी ऑफ वेपर, एंड ड्राई एयर कैन बी एक्सप्रेस्ड एज kg of dry air. So omega has a unit of kg vapor per kg of what? Dry air. My dear students, all of you, are you following? All of you, are you following? Oh my god, 30 50 are you? Bas, bas, very happy, very bas. excellent students of India, excellent, number one batch in India. Chalo, now stop. I said, now omega mil gaya. What is omega? Mass of vapor to the mass of vapor to the mass of Amit Kumar Singh. No sir, are you following or not? Amit sir, boliye kya dikkat hai? Okay, 108 said, yes, 108. Chalo. Now, the first term that we saw is what? First term that we saw is what? Omega. What is omega? Mass of vapor to the mass of dry air. Excellent, excellent, my dear students. Now, let's go to the second term. So, I'll take the new slide. Let's go to the second term. The second term is dry bulb temperature, dry bulb temperature, DBT. Now let's see what is dry bulb temperature, my dear students. Let us take a thermometer. Now air is flowing. Whenever I say air, it is moist air. So isme kya kya hai, isme kya kya hai? Dry air and water vapor, dry air and water vapor. Okay, in dry air what do we have? मास बाय मास, नो यूनिट ना. आई सेड केजी ऑफ वेपर पर केजी ऑफ ड्राई एयर. मेरा कहने का मकसद है, अगर 1000 ग्राम ऑफ ड्राई एयर लिए, उसमें 4 ग्राम वेपर है. दैट इज द मीनिंग आई सेड. सो व्हाट आई मीन इज केजी वेपर पर केजी ड्राई एयर. डियर केयरफुली देखो आप. ओके, नाउ हैव अ लुक एट दिस. वेरी गुड. व्हाई स्टूडेंट आस्क व्हाट इज द फिजिकल सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ ओमेगा. माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, ओमेगा एक्चुअली रिप्रेजेंट्स एक ड्राई एयर. अगर आप लेंगे, अगर आप ड्राई एयर लेंगे, उस ड्राई एयर में यू टेक सम एयर, सम मॉइस्ट एयर, उसमें देर इज सम वाटर वेपर, देर इज सम ड्राई एयर. तो कितना वेपर है और कितना ड्राई एयर है, उसके रिलेटिव वैल्यूज को दिखाता है ओमेगा. सो ओमेगा क्या दिखा रहा है? इन पर्टिकुलर यू टेक मॉइस्ट एयर, उस मॉइस्ट एयर में कितना वाटर वेपर है और कितना ड्राई एयर है, उसको दिखाता है रिलेटिव वैल्यूज ऑफ बोथ. नाउ लेट मी कम एंड आंसर टू योर क्वेश्चंस प्लीज सर. नाउ बिकॉज़ द टाइम इज वेरी लेस, सो नाउ बिकॉज़ स्पेशल क्लास का मतलब 1 आवर का होता है, तो आई हैव टू कवर. चलो, टू गिव द टेस्ट ऑफ वेरियस कॉन्सेप्ट्स. नाउ दिस बल्ब, इसको हम बोलते हैं बल्ब. नाउ ऑब्जर्व हियर, एयर इज फ्लोइंग. Which air is flowing? Moist air. मतलब क्या क्या है उसमें? Dry air है, water vapor है, moisture is flowing. अगर अरे यार आप टीवी में देखते हैं और टीवी पे देखते हैं और क्या है एंड न्यूज़पेपर में देखते हैं, आज का न्यूनतम टेम्परेचर, मैक्सिमम टेम्परेचर, मिनिमम टेम्परेचर, दिस आर ऑल ड्राई बल्ब टेम्परेचर. ड्राई बल्ब टेम्परेचर इज नथिंग बट इट इज द टेम्परेचर ऑफ एयर measured, normal temperature of air, normal, मतलब आप बोलते हैं अब तापमान है 28 degree, now the temperature is 28 degrees, that is nothing but dry bulb temperature, it is the normal temperature of air measured by an ordinary thermometer. So what is dry bulb temperature? It is the normal temperature of air measured by an ordinary thermometer. Measured by an ordinary thermometer. Excellent. अब देखना ध्यान से, मैं थोड़ा कुछ अलग वे में बताऊंगा आपको. तो थोड़ा if you want to understand clearly, let us start. So, what is dry bulb temperature? It is the normal temperature of air measured by an ordinary thermometer. Now, have a look at this, my dear students. Please, let's understand carefully now. Okay, one second, please. Don't worry. Yeah. Right. Okay. Now, let's observe carefully. Let us take temperature entropy diagram. And please observe here, we'll be discussing in thermo how we get this shape. All those we'll be discussing in detail. Aap jante hai, ye toh kya hai ye? Vapor. Aur ye kya hai? Liquid vapor. Aur ye kya hai? Liquid. So now tell me, how is water vapor in air existing? आप तो जानते हैं, अगर आप एयर देखो, जब आप एयर को देखेंगे तो आपको पानी पानी नहीं दिख रहा है, पूरा वो किस स्टेट में है, वेपर स्टेट। मतलब माई एयर, माई वॉटर वेपर इन एयर, मेरा वॉटर वेपर एयर में इस स्टेट में है, वेपर स्टेट में है, वेपर स्टेट में है, मीन्स वॉटर वे, इस रीजन को हम सुपर हीटेड रीजन भी बोलते हैं। सो नाउ ऑब्जर्व हियर, वॉटर वेपर जो एयर में है, इट एग्जिस्ट इन व्हाट स्टेट? सुपर हीटेड स्टेट। आई रिपीट, वॉटर वेपर इन एयर एग्जिस्ट इन व्हाट? सुपर हीटेड स्टेट। अरे नमूने, अगर आप एयर लेंगे तो देर इज ड्राई पार्ट, देर इज वॉटर वेपर, पूरा स्प्रेड होगा तो आप डिफरेंशिएट नहीं कर पाएंगे, पूरा वेपर गैस स्टेट में है तो इट इज इन सुपर हीटेड स्टेट। मतलब, लेकिन आप तो जानते हैं, ध्यान से सुनो, इफ आई टेक एयर, टेम्परेचर ऑफ ड्राई एयर is equal to temperature of water vapor. Temperature of dry air is equal to temperature of water vapor. इसका मतलब मेरे सारे air का temperature क्या है? TI. उस temperature को हम बोलते हैं dry bulb temperature. तो ये जो diagram है, this diagram, it is not for dry air. So जब भी आप ये diagram show करते हैं, ये phase change जो हो रहा है उसके लिए, तो phase change कौन सा हो रहा है? Water vapor हो रहा है. मतलब ये जो diagram दिखा रहा है हम, वो केवल water vapor के लिए है. It is not for dry air. It is for water vapor. क्योंकि ये जो है phase change का दिखाता है. It shows phase change diagram. It shows phase change diagram. So water vapor is undergoing phase change. Therefore ये diagram जो है, वो किसके लिए है? This diagram is for water vapor. And how is water vapor in air existing? It is existing in superheated state. मान लो ये टेम्परेचर है, let us assume that this is the temperature. Let us say मेरे एयर का टेम्परेचर है, मान लो 30 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. This temperature is same 30 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. And why are you showing water vapor here? And whether it is water vapor or dry air, both are at what temperature? 30 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. So ये मेरा टेम्परेचर हो गया, this is my temperature. लेकिन ये किसका टेम्परेचर है? वॉटर वेपर का. लेकिन वॉटर वेपर एंड ड्रायर दोनों भी एक ही टेम्परेचर पे है, तो इट इज द टेम्परेचर ऑफ एयर. दो आई एम शोइंग फॉर वॉटर वेपर, इट इज द टेम्परेचर ऑफ एयर. एंड यू नो वॉटर वेपर का पार्शियल प्रेशर क्या है? पीवी. वॉटर वेपर का पार्शियल प्रेशर क्या है? पीवी. सो पासिंग थ्रू दिस ड्रॉ अ कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर लाइन. पासिंग थ्रू दिस ड्रॉ a constant pressure line. Let us draw a constant pressure line, my dear students. So this is my constant pressure line. This is my constant pressure line. And this is actually for vapor. That's why I write it as PV. So mera water vapor is state pe hai. Toh ye kaun sa temperature hoga? Please understand carefully. Jo water vapor air mein hai, wo kis state mein hai? सुपरहीटेड स्टेट में है. अगर सुपरहीटेड स्टेट में होगा तो इस रीजन में दिखाएंगे. और वाटर वेपर का प्रेशर क्या है? पार्शियल प्रेशर क्या है? पीवी है. तो उसका पार्शियल प्रेशर पीवी है, उसका टेम्परेचर टी है. तो ये मेरा पॉइंट किसका होगा? इट इज द स्टेट ऑफ वाटर वेपर विच इज प्रेजेंट इन एयर. एक्सलेंट. एंड दैट टेम्परेचर इज ड्राई बल्ब टेम्परेचर. तो आप पूछ सकते हैं, सर ये टेम्परेचर तो, सर ये तो वेपर का है, फिर आप एयर का क्यों बोल रहे हैं? अरे नमूने, वाटर वेपर हो या ड्राई एयर हो या पूरा एयर, एक ही टेम्परेचर पे एग्जिस्ट हो रहा है. इसलिए अगर आप वाटर वेपर को शो करेंगे, इसका मतलब वो वाटर वेपर का भी है, ड्राई एयर का भी है और पूरा एयर का भी है. सो व्हेन आई शो दिस एज अ पॉइंट, इट इज फॉर वाटर वेपर. क्योंकि ये सारा डायग्राम वाटर वेपर के लिए बनता है, ड्राई एयर के लिए नहीं बनता. रहे नमूने. Okay, right. Now observe here. This is my dry bulb temperature. Please observe. अब मैं क्या करता हूँ? Dry bulb, wet bulb, dew point, all I'll superimpose. So ये कौन सा temperature है? इसको देखो. This is my dry bulb temperature. So I'll also write this as dry bulb temperature. Okay, excellent. Excellent. Now ये हो गया मेरा dry bulb temperature. Can you tell me what is dry bulb temperature? It is the temperature of air. Normal temperature of air measured by an ordinary thermometer. Normal temperature of air measured by ordinary thermometer. Excellent. अब आएंगे next concept which is very very important. Wet bulb temperature. Wet bulb temperature. Wet bulb temperature. Excellent. Listen, अभी कोई कमेंट नहीं करना है. अगर ज्वाइन हो रहे तो ठीक है, लेकिन कमेंट मत करना. जस्ट अंडरस्टैंड कॉन्सेप्ट्स, विल एंजॉय द सब्जेक्ट. ऑब्जर्व हियर माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेट बल्ब टेम्परेचर. व्हाट इज वेट बल्ब टेम्परेचर? ध्यान से सुनो. यू टेक अ थर्मोमीटर, कवर दैट थर्मोमीटर बाई a wet cotton cloth. आप तुम सोच रहे होंगे ये क्या हो रहा है सर, एक बार बल्ब ऐसा है तो आप इसका टेम्परेचर कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं, उसके बाद इसको एक क्लॉथ से सराउंड कर रहा है और टेम्परेचर मेजर कर रहा है, ये क्या है? नाउ स्टॉप, अब थोड़ा एंजॉय करेंगे, लेट्स एंजॉय, एंड इट्स माय हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू, 10 मिनट के लिए नो वन शुड कमेंट, एवरीवन शुड लुक आइदर एट स्क्रीन और माय हैंड मूवमेंट्स. So, if I am not writing anything on screen, just look at my hand movements. Okay, chalo. Now, my dear students, just now we saw this is my tears diagram. Okay. This is partial pressure of vapor, and you said this is the dry bulb temperature. I assume it to be some 30, not necessarily always 30. Assume it to be some 30 degree centigrade. Excellent. ये कौन सा point है? What is this point? This point is this temperature is dry bulb temperature. Look at carefully now. इसको थोड़ा इरेज करेंगे हम, सो आई विल इरेज दिस, इसको इरेज करेंगे और आई विल शो इट हियर. नाउ इट इज कवर्ड बाय अ वेट क्लॉथ एंड प्लीज नोट डाउन दैट CLOTH क्लॉथ. And it is always saturated with water. मतलब पानी का कोई कमी नहीं. It is always okay. अब देखना. Okay, please observe. Understand carefully. This is the cloth. This is the wet cloth. This is the wet cloth. Now, observe carefully. अब आराम से पढ़ेंगे हम. Happily we'll study. Okay. Now, air is flowing. Which air? Unsaturated air. What do we mean by unsaturated? मतलब देखो ये जो point है ना इसको हम बोलते हैं unsaturated. अगर ये point यहाँ पे होता है इसको saturated vapor बोलते हैं. Like this is saturated vapor. But where is our vapor here? So this we call it as unsaturated. So अगर ये point यहाँ पे होता है उसको बोलते हैं हम saturated vapor. Now our unsaturated air is flowing over the cotton wick, cotton cloth. What do you mean by unsaturated? इसका मतलब उस पर्टिकुलर टेम्परेचर पर एयर कैन होल्ड सम मॉइस्चर, मतलब एयर थोड़ा मॉइस्चर ले सकता सर्टन अमाउंट. अगर जितना उसका क्षमता है जितना वॉट एवर द कैपेसिटी, सो टू द मैक्सिमम इफ यू हैव वन लोम इन 1000 ग्राम ऑफ एयर इट कैन होल्ड 80 ग्राम. If it is less, it cannot hold beyond 80. 80 के 80 से ज़्यादा तो chance ही नहीं है, because maximum is 80. That is saturated. If it is less than 80, so अगर air में 1000 gram air, dry air में, अगर ध्यान से सुनो, 80 gram से कम है, if it is less than 80, you call it as what unsaturated air. Now मतलब 80 चाहिए उसको, लेकिन 80 नहीं है, मान लो 40 है. तो क्या करेगा? अगर पानी दिखेगा तरस रहा है पानी के लिए, अगर पानी दिखेगा तो वो एब्जॉर्ब करने की कोशिश करेगा. सो दिस अनसैचुरेटेड एयर इज फ्लोइंग ओवर द कॉटन क्लॉथ. ध्यान से सुनो ना, नाउ दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई रिपीट, ये थोड़ा कॉम्प्लिकेटेड कॉन्सेप्ट है, थोड़ा ध्यान से सुनो. दोज़ हू हैव जॉइन्ड नाउ, यू हैव टू बी वेरी वेरी केयरफुल. अनसैचुरेटेड एयर इज फ्लोइंग ओवर दिस, तो लेट अस अज्यूम दैट this is the surface molecule of water. ये पूरा पानी है. देखो ये cloth is completely wetted, पूरा saturated. मतलब पूरा, what do you mean by saturated? पानी में ऐसा भिगा है कि और वो ज़्यादा पानी absorb नहीं कर सकता. तो ये पूरा, it is completely water. It cannot absorb more than that. हो गया. Now this is water. So when air is coming, that air needs water vapor. अब एयर को क्या चाहिए? वाटर वेपर चाहिए. क्यों चाहिए? क्योंकि इट इज अनसैचुरेटेड. तो सैचुरेटेड होने के लिए, टू रीच सैचुरेशन, इट नीड सम वाटर वेपर. इट नीड सम वाटर वेपर. सो व्हाट इट इज डूइंग, यू नो, लुक एट Now, what it is doing? Observe carefully. My dear students, observe carefully. So, let's take one. From the inside, this surface, this is the surface water molecule. This is surface water molecule. Listen. Don't comment. Surface water. This is surface water molecule. ये तो सरफेस पे है तो इट कैन इजीली ओवरकम कोहेसिव फोर्सेस. सो अगर अंदर है तो दिक्कत होगा लेकिन सरफेस पे है इट कैन इजीली ओवरकम कोहेसिव फोर्सेस और वो इवेपोरेट होने की कोशिश करा लेकिन इस एयर को पानी चाहिए क्योंकि वो अनसैचुरेटेड है लेकिन दैट माय एयर कैन अब्सॉर्ब वाटर ओनली इफ इट इज इन वेपर स्टेट. तो ये जो सरफेस मॉलिक्यूल्स है ना पहले वो लिक्विड सरफेस मॉलिक्यूल्स वेपर में कन्वर्ट होना चाहिए नहीं तो एयर नहीं लेगा. अब ध्यान से सुनो ये फरार होना चाह रहा है ये अपने हीरो के साथ. लेट अस अज्यूम अनसैचुरेटेड एयर इज हीरो. लेट अस अज्यूम द सरफेस मॉलिक्यूल इज हीरोइन. अब ये सरफेस मॉलिक्यूल हीरोइन हीरो के साथ जाना चाह रहा है लेकिन कोई ना कोई क्या करना चाहिए हेल्प करना चाहिए. तो ये क्या कर अरे यार दोनों का सपोर्ट होते ही कंबाइन हो जाएंगे. तो ये सरफेस मॉलिक्यूल क्या कर रहा है जरा उसको किसमें कन्वर्ट होना है द सरफेस मॉलिक्यूल शुड बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू वेपर. तो इट नीड्स लेटेंट हीट. सो जो एनर्जी लिक्विड को वेपर में कन्वर्ट कर रहा है फेस चेंज के लिए हीट चाहिए इट इज लेटेंट हीट. तो पहले ये सरफेस मॉलिक्यूल क्या करता है अंदर से थोड़ा हीट लेता है अंदर से. तो जब अंदर से हीट लेता है तो यहां पे लोकली लो टेम्परेचर होगा. आई रिपीट माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स जो सरफेस का मॉलिक्यूल है ना सो अंदर जो पानी है उससे हीट ले रहा है. जो सरफेस वाटर मॉलिक्यूल अंदर से हीट लेगा जब अंदर से हीट लेगा सो अंदर लोकली टेम्परेचर कम होगा. जब लोकली टेम्परेचर यहां पे कम होगा अब ये रेडी होगा. देखो हीरो चांस के लिए वेट कर रहा था कब चांस मिलेगा इसको हीट देके उसको वेपर में कन्वर्ट करके उड़ा के ले जाने के लिए दिल वाले दुल्हनिया ले जाएंगे. नाउ लुक एट दिस एयर इज रेडी टू टेक मॉइस्चर लेकिन मॉइस्चर लेने के लिए वो वेट कर रहा है. तो पहले जो सरफेस मॉलिक्यूल है ना जो सरफेस का वाटर है वाटर मॉलिक्यूल जो अंदर से हीट ले रहा है जब अंदर से हीट ले रहा है तो लोकली अंदर का टेम्परेचर कम होगा. जब टेम्परेचर कम होगा अब एयर क्या करेगा हीट देगा. जब एयर हीट दे रहा है तो एयर का टेम्परेचर कम हो रहा है. एयर का टेम्परेचर जब कम होगा तो ये नीचे आना चाहिए नीचे आना चाहिए इट शुड कम डाउन. सो नाउ माय सरफेस वाटर मॉलिक्यूल इज अब्सॉर्बिंग हीट फ्रॉम इनसाइड. तो लोकली द टेम्परेचर इज ड्रॉपिंग. व्हेन द टेम्परेचर इज ड्रॉपिंग माय एयर इज गिविंग हीट. जब हीट ले रहा है तुरंत मेरा लिक्विड अब वेपर में कन्वर्ट हो रहा है मतलब देयर इज साइमल्टेनियसली हीट ट्रांसफर फ्रॉम एयर मास ट्रांसफर. अरे आर यू फॉलोइंग All of you, are you following? Are you following? Are you following? Oh, my lovely students, in 2 seconds, 88, yes, love you all. Chalo, ab dekho, kya ho raha hai? Dhyan se suno, ye hai. To iske surface ke upar water hai. To wo water kya kar raha hai? Zara sa andar se heat le raha hai. To jab andar se, when it is taking heat slightly from inside, locally the temperature is dropping. Now air is giving heat. Why it is giving heat? Kyunki usko vapor chahiye. Why it is giving heat? If it is not in need of vapor, it will not give heat. So it is giving heat, taking vapor. So when air is giving heat, the air temperature is decreasing. When air is absorbing moisture, its moisture content is increasing. When moisture content is increasing, the partial pressure of vapor is increasing. I repeat, air kya kar raha hai? Dhyan se suno. वेट कर रहा है उसको लेने के लिए वेट कर रहा है. तो पहले सरफेस मॉलिक्यूल क्या किया है सरफेस मॉलिक्यूल अंदर से हीट लिया. जब अंदर से हीट लिया व्हेन इट हैज टेकन फ्रॉम इनसाइड लोकली टेम्परेचर ड्रॉप हुआ. व्हेन लोकली टेम्परेचर ड्रॉप हुआ तो एयर हीट दे रहा हाई टेम्परेचर लो टेम्परेचर. व्हेन एयर इज लूजिंग हीट गेनिंग मॉइस्चर. एयर इज लूजिंग हीट गेनिंग मॉइस्चर. तो हीट देने के बाद वो जो वॉटर है वेपर में कन्वर्ट होगा. तो एयर इज बट पहले पोटेंशियल क्रिएट करने के लिए वो अंदर से ले रहा है. व्हेन इट टेक्स फ्रॉम इनसाइड लोकली द टेम्परेचर इज ड्रॉपिंग हाई टेम्परेचर लो टेम्परेचर. व्हेन हीट इज हु इज गिविंग हीट एयर. सो व्हेन एयर इज गिविंग हीट व्हाट इज हैपनिंग टू इट्स टेम्परेचर इट इज डिक्रीजिंग. सो इट इज डिक्रीजिंग इट इज डिक्रीजिंग इट इज डिक्रीजिंग. एंड व्हाट इज हैपनिंग एयर इज ऑल्सो अब्सॉर्बिंग मॉइस्चर. सो व्हेन इट इज अब्सॉर्बिंग मॉइस्चर द पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ वेपर इज इंक्रीजिंग. सो इफ आई फॉलो दिस लाइन इट इज अ कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर लाइन. सो इट इज नॉट फॉलोइंग कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर लाइन इट इज absorbing moisture, losing heat, absorbing moisture, losing heat. So it has to follow the answers, you know, like this. तो आप पूछेंगे ऐसा क्यों, ऐसा क्यों? अगर वो ऐसा फॉलो करता है तो सेम प्रेशर. सो इट इज नॉट पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ वेपर इज नॉट कॉन्स्टेंट. क्यों? क्योंकि व्हेन एयर इज अब्सॉर्बिंग मॉइस्चर पार्शियल प्रेशर ऑफ वेपर इज इंक्रीजिंग, मींस इट शुड मूव टुवर्ड्स हायर वेपर प्रेशर. तो नीचे से ऊपर का प्रेशर ज्यादा है. सो इफ आई ड्रॉ अ कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर लाइन, देखो एक बार, प्लीज ऑब्जर्व This is a constant pressure line. So, देखो, हमारा एयर क्या कर रहा है? ऐसा मूव हो रहा है, ऐसा मूव हो रहा है, ऐसा मूव हो रहा है. So, let us take this point. तो इधर क्या है बोलो? इससे ये टेम्परेचर कम है. क्यों टेम्परेचर घट गया? क्योंकि एयर हीट लूज कर रहा है. क्यों पार्शियल प्रेशर बढ़ गया? इससे ये प्रेशर ज्यादा है. Why the partial pressure has got increased? Because it is absorbing moisture. So how long it is occurring? वो हीट दे रहा है, वेपर ले रहा है. हीट दे रहा है, वेपर ले रहा है. कितना देर होगा वो? Until वेपर ले, वो किस तरफ आ रहा है? देखो धीरे धीरे वो किस तरफ आ रहा है? सैचुरेशन की तरफ आएगा. सैचुरेशन के बाद वो नहीं लेगा. मीन्स इफ आई टेक अ न्यू स्लाइड, माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ ऑब्जर्व हियर, ऑब्जर्व हियर, प्लीज ऑब्जर्व. दिस इज माई TS प्लॉट. This is my TS plot. Look at. And this is my dry bulb temperature. So this is my dry bulb temperature. Wait. Hold on. This is dry bulb temperature. And if you draw a line, this is the partial pressure of vapor. Already you know, ये तो vapor का है. But our air is following. देखो ध्यान से. वो ऊपर की तरफ जा रहा है. टेम्परेचर क्यों घट रहा है? कैन एनीवन टेल व्हाई द टेम्परेचर ऑफ एयर इज डिक्रीजिंग? नो वन इज कमेंटिंग व्हाई द टेम्परेचर ऑफ एयर इज डिक्रीजिंग. यस, एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी. इट इज लूजिंग हीट. So why the partial pressure of vapor is increasing? It is gaining moisture. That's why वो इस तरफ जा रहा है. कब तक जाएगा? देखो, stop. कब तक होगा? It will lose heat, gain moisture. When it is gaining moisture, तो higher pressure की तरफ. Until it reaches what? Saturation. Losing heat, gaining moisture. How long? Until it reaches saturation state. देखो. Losing heat, temperature drop हो रहा है. ऊपर क्यों जा रहा है? Partial pressure of vapor बढ़ रहा है. क्यों बढ़ रहा है? क्योंकि it is gaining moisture. When it is gaining moisture, partial pressure of vapor is increasing. How long? Until it reaches saturation. Oh my God! This particular saturation temperature, we call it as wet bulb temperature. तो ये कौन सा air है? It is unsaturated air. तो unsaturated air के लिए dry bulb कभी भी ज्यादा होता है और wet bulb कभी भी कम होता है. Unsaturated air के लिए dry bulb is always more, wet bulb is less. Now the question comes, sir ji, why do we measure wet bulb temperature? Excellent. Why do we measure wet bulb temperature? No comments, please. No comments. Why do we measure wet bulb temperature? So dekho, what is wet bulb temperature? In the process of losing heat and gaining moisture, there is simultaneous heat transfer, mass transfer until it reaches saturation. That particular saturation temperature is known as wet bulb temperature. वो हीट लूज कर रहा है, मॉइस्चर ले रहा है. मॉइस्चर कब तक खाएगा वो? सैचुरेशन, पेट भर गया. उस पेट भरने का टेम्परेचर को, जो सैचुरेशन टेम्परेचर, वी कॉल इट एज व्हाट? But sir, water vapor temperature is increasing. See, my dear students, when I say air, in air, dry air and water vapor is always in equilibrium. So please, I'll answer to your question. Let me complete this first. Okay. Now you have a question. Why do we measure wet bulb temperature? What is the significance of wet bulb temperature? Answer soon. Let us take first air, second air. Manlo, my dear students, एक जगह पे ड्राई बल्ब टेम्परेचर है 30 और यहां पे भी ड्राई बल्ब टेम्परेचर है 30. अरे देयर इज सम प्लेस एंड ये दोनों अलग अलग प्लेस है. प्लेस वन एंड दिस इज प्लेस टू. तो यहां पे वेट बल्ब टेम्परेचर मान लो 20 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड है और यहां पे वेट बल्ब टेम्परेचर है मान लो 28 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, केयरफुली, देयर आर टू डिफरेंट प्लेसेस. एट वन प्लेस द ड्राई बल्ब टेम्परेचर इज 30 एंड अदर प्लेस ड्राई बल्ब इज आल्सो 30. द वाटर वेट बल्ब टेम्परेचर एट वन प्लेस इज 20, एट अदर प्लेस इट इज 28 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. नाउ The difference in these two temperatures, we call it as wet bulb depression. So now tell me, what is the wet bulb temperature? Wet depression, wet bulb minus dry bulb. So wet bulb temperature minus dry bulb temperature, and that is given by 30 minus 20 is 10. Now here, the wet bulb depression is given by 30 minus 20, it is 2 degrees centigrade. And here it is 10 degrees centigrade. Matlab, first place pe wet bulb depression hai 10 degree, aur dusre place pe hai wet bulb depression 2 degree hai. Chalo dekhenge kya farak hai. Suno dhyan se. My dear students, don't try it. Don't try it. Look at my dear students. Look at. Sorry, this is dry bulb minus wet bulb. I'm sorry. This is dry bulb minus wet bulb. Yes, exactly. So that's why it is 30 minus 20 is 10 degree. Dry bulb minus wet bulb. So yahan pe wet bulb depression hoga 10 degree centigrade. Chalo dhyan se suno. Dhyan se suno. Isme first case mein jo wet bulb hai kam ho raha, kam hai. Bahut kam hai. Now tell me, क्यों कम हो गया? क्योंकि उसके पास moisture बहुत कम था initially. तो moisture लेने के लिए वो अपना heat खो रहा है. जब वो heat खो रहा है, see I repeat, in first case the moisture content in air is less. When the moisture content in air is less, it will absorb more. In the process of absorbing more heat, in the process of absorbing more moisture, it has to lose more heat. I repeat, usko agar zyada moisture chahiye to zyada heat khona hai, tabhi wo moisture lega. To zyada heat jab kho raha hai, uska temperature kam ho raha hai. So second case mein dekhna, dekho idhar, please observe here. Second case, what is the difference? Just 2 degrees. Matlab isme moisture content kya hai, zyada hai. To isliye wo only, it is losing some amount. I repeat, Idhar dekhna. What is the dry bulb temperature? 30 degrees centigrade. Isme moisture, jo water vapor, jo air mein hai, less hai. Isiliye wo zyada lega. Jab moisture content air mein kam hai, to wo definitely zyada lega. So zyada lene ki koshish karega. When it is taking more, zyada lene ke liye, usko zyada heat lose karna padega. So jab zyada heat lose kar raha hai, uska temperature bahut ghat jayega. So wet bulb temperature is indicating moisture content in air. Agar donon ka farak bahut zyada hai, iska matlab jo air hai usme, in that air the, I repeat, come here. So now let us assume that the wet bulb is 30 and the dry bulb is 30. Listen carefully. So what is the wet bulb depression? Zero. What does it mean? There is no difference in wet bulb and dry bulb. The reason is, this we call it as saturated air. Why do we call it as saturated air? Kyunki when both, look at, now observe here, this is saturated air. Agar actually originally mera dry bulb temperature yaha pe tha, dry bulb temperature, ab wo dry bulb temperature yaha aa gaya, maan lo ek saturated state aur saturated state, agar ye maan lo mera air yaha pe hai, matlab ye mera point yaha pe hai, maan lo yaha pe, so it is saturated. So already it is saturated. When already it is saturated, will it absorb heat? Will it absorb moisture? No. When it is not absorbing moisture, it will not lose heat. So ye heat transfer, mass transfer kyun ho raha hai? Kyunki air mein agar moisture content kam hota hai, if the moisture content in air is less, it will absorb more. Agar more absorb kar raha hai, it has to lose more heat. So when it is losing more heat, the temperature is dropping more, so wet bulb is coming down. So whenever the difference in dry bulb and wet bulb is large, it means in that air the moisture content is less, so it will absorb more. In the process of absorbing more heat, in the process of absorbing more moisture, it loses more heat. When it is losing more heat, the temperature will drop down. So my wet bulb temperature is indicating the moisture content in air. I repeat, wet bulb temperature is indicating the moisture content in air. So therefore, now observe carefully, my dear students. Please observe here. 1 second. I repeat. So if the wet bulb, see, maan lo, mai bata raha, let us assume that it is saturated air. 1 second, please. let us assume that it is saturated air. Let us say its temperature is 28 degree centigrade. मतलब ये मेरा dry bulb temperature है. Okay, ये कौन सा air है? Saturated air. अब same air हम clock से surround करेंगे. Same air. What is the dry bulb temperature? 28 degree centigrade. Now let us calculate the wet bulb temperature of this air. Already it is saturated. So when it is already saturated, will it absorb moisture? It वो तो saturate हो गया. It will not absorb. When it is not absorbing, so it is not giving up heat. So when it is not giving up heat, so therefore automatic equilibrium is reached. When automatic equilibrium is reached, my dry bulb will be equal to what? Wet bulb temperature. I repeat, my dear students, फिर से बता रहा हूँ सुनिए. All of you, are you following? All of you, are you following? Oh, awesome, awesome. Stop. फिर से बता रहा हूँ सुनो. Wet bulb temperature actually indicates moisture content in air. अगर wet bulb temperature dry bulb से बहुत कम है, अगर wet bulb temperature dry bulb से बहुत कम है, if the wet bulb temperature is very much lower than dry bulb temperature, means in that air moisture is less. That's why to pick up more moisture, it is losing more heat. When it is losing more heat, it will gain more moisture. So why it is gaining more moisture? It has less. So now already it is saturated air. When already it is saturated air, when it is saturated air, it cannot pick up any more amount of moisture. When it is not picking up any more moisture, it is not losing it. When it is not losing it, automatic equilibrium is reached. So that's why for saturated air, dry bulb temperature is equal to wet bulb temperature. Is equal to wet bulb temperature. Dry bulb. Kis air ke liye? Saturated air. So wet bulb depression is equal to what? Wet bulb depression, which is dry bulb temperature minus wet bulb temperature, and that is equal to, when both are same, it is 28 minus 28, which is equal to zero. So wet bulb depression is zero when air is saturated. Matlab agar hum dekhte hain, to actually agar dry bulb yahan pe hai, agar dry bulb yahan pe hai, to saturated ke liye wet bulb bhi yahan pe hoga. So in this case, dBT is equal to wBT. But already we have seen for unsaturated air, this is the dry bulb temperature and this is our wet bulb temperature. So please observe carefully, my dear students. Please observe my dear students. For unsaturated air, dry bulb is always greater than wet bulb temperature. So what is the significance of wet bulb temperature? It shows the moisture content in air. Agar air mein moisture content zyada hai, if it is more, means it needs only little to reach saturation, little to reach saturation. So for gaining saturation, it needs bahut kam moisture chahiye. To kam moisture chahiye, to kam heat khoga. Jab kam heat khoga, to difference kya hoga? Bahut kam hoga. So for saturated air, it is always dry bulb is equal to what? Wet bulb. Now, my dear students, let's observe one important point. Let's go to dew point temperature, dBT. And after this, we'll stop and I'll continue this topic because it's not possible to complete. I'll continue this topic in the next special class. कभी आप देखे विंटर में आप मॉर्निंग वॉकिंग के लिए गए या फिर ऐसा करेंगे हम देखो बॉटल वन बॉटल टू ध्यान से सुनो बॉटल टू दिस इज वेरी कूल इट इज वेरी कूल ओ गॉड ऑलरेडी मॉइस्चर कंटेंट इज शोन बाय स्पेसिफिक ह्यूमिडिटी नो सर एक्सलेंट Manti Rao Sai Kiran. Very good. Actually, it's very difficult to measure omega. So it is easy to measure wet bulb temperature. So from wet bulb temperature, we go to omega actually. So it is very easy to measure wet bulb temperature. That's why wet bulb aane ke baad hum omega, relative humidity, all this we can easily do it. That's why we go for wet bulb temperature. It is very cool. And it is not that cool, but cool. So you might have observed. On this surface, so when air is flowing, you see some droplets. But on this surface, it's cool, but not that cool. It's cool, but not that cool. You don't see moisture content on this. अरे नमूने मैं बताता हूँ. जब विंटर में आप सुबह मॉर्निंग वॉक के लिए गए, तो घास के ऊपर you see dew drops. Same thing in summer when you go, you don't see. The reason is in winter, in nights, the temperatures are dropping. So, ab kya ho raha hai dekhenge? Please observe, my dear students. This is my dry bulb temperature. And this is our partial pressure of vapor. Now, aisa karo aap. Cool the air. Cool the air. And aisa karo, ek bottle le lo. Aur air flow ho raha hai. Take a bottle and air is flowing. I'm not changing the pressure. Means, let us say the bottle is at 10 degrees centigrade. Okay, aisa karunga. So I'll do one thing. Let this temperature be some 30 degrees centigrade. Already you have seen this wet bulb temperature. Let this temperature be wet bulb. Ye to DBT hoga, dry bulb. Ye wet bulb, let us say 24 degrees centigrade. Maan lo, ye jo temperature, I don't know how much is. Let us say it is, this temperature is 18 degrees centigrade. So no, in winter, what is happening? Morning temperatures are very low. Means, isse bhi kam hote hai. But in summer, morning temperatures are not that low. So, isiliye summer mein aap walking kar rahe hai, to air is cooling, but it is falling. Jab air flow ho raha hai, it is a constant pressure process. So, isiliye we have to follow constant pressure. Lekin wet bulb mein, you should not follow constant pressure, kyunki moisture is increasing, that's why wet bulb is not falling constant pressure. But in dew point, air is cooled at a constant pressure. So I should follow strictly this line. Winter, summer mein kya ho raha hai? Maan lo, this temperature is, let us say, some 20 degrees centigrade. So summer mein kya ho raha hai? Isse zyada hai. Isse zyada hai. Therefore, isse zyada hai. So it is just cooling, but it is not touching this liquid state, this saturated vapor state. So ghas ke upar jo dew dikh raha hai, to aapko iska matlab kya hai? Wo temperature kya hai? Is temperature se kam hai. That's why when air is cooled at a constant pressure, after some point it reaches this temperature. Is particular temperature se agar wo cool ho raha hai, to it's the dew, matlab moisture content, jo vapor jo air mein, it starts condensing. So it is the first drop, it is this point where the first droplet of moisture is formed, and that temperature you call it as what temperature? This particular temperature I call it as what? Dew point temperature. So what is dew point temperature? It is the temperature at which water vapor in air starts condensing. Matlab jab air flow ho raha hai, agar iska temperature bahut hi kam hai, to it will reach this particular temperature. When it reaches this particular temperature, so water vapor in air starts condensing. Agar dhyan se suno, agar air yahan tak aa gaya, cool ho raha hai, cool ho raha hai, but yahan pe kya ho raha hai? Is case mein, in this case, wo yahi tak cool ho gaya. Matlab, it has not reached dew point temperature. It has not reached this temperature. But in this case, it's very cool. So therefore, it has dropped down from 20 to 18. That's why moisture content is formed. That's why moisture content is formed. So what is dew point temperature? It is the temperature at which water vapor in air starts condensing. Or it is the temperature at which first droplet of water vapor is formed. All of you, are you following? All of you, are you following? All of, oh my God, 100 into, oh, stop, 115, array, stop. Excellent. Now, dhyan se suno, my dear students. Please observe. Please stop. So, if I show you, stop. This is my dry bulb temperature. And this is partial pressure of vapor. And you know very well, this is my wet bulb temperature, and you are cooling at a constant pressure, dew point reach hone ke liye constant pressure. This is my dew point. So agar hum plot karenge, dekho, this is my dry bulb temperature, this is my wet bulb temperature, and this is my dew point temperature. Dhyan se suno, order dekho, kaun sa temperature zyada hai? Dry bulb is greater than wet bulb, which is greater than dew point temperature. So whenever there is unsaturated air, always remember, dry bulb is greater than wet bulb, is greater than dew point temperature. Now let me take, oh my god, so 1 second. I'm sorry. Dekho ek bar. Please, now observe here. So now understand carefully. Agar we have stop saturated air. Ye kaun sa air hai? Unsaturated air hai. Agar air saturated hoga, to mera dry bulb kahan pe hoga? If it is unsaturated, it is air. Agar saturated hai, to kahin pe hoga? Yahi pe hoga. Abhi aap dekhe, saturated air ke liye dry bulb, wet bulb kya hoga? Dry bulb aur wet bulb kya hoga? Same hoga. Lekin jab cool karenge, isi point pe water vapor condense hona shuru hoga. So that means it is also dew point temperature. For saturated air, dry bulb is equal to wet bulb is equal to dew point temperature. For unsaturated air, dry bulb is greater than wet bulb is greater than dew point temperature. All of you, have you followed? Excellent. Oh my God, 150. Stop. Now today, what we have learned is, I missed one term. Purposefully, I missed. Because relative humidity. Because actually, we have to show you. When relative humidity is more, then how will the rain come? How will it happen? We will show you all. So please observe carefully, my dear students. All of you, have you followed? Excellent. So we will do this. Please understand, my dear students. I'll take five more minutes and stop for today. Please bear with me for 5 more minutes. And this class will continue. Again, a special class will continue further. So please. Dekho, oh my God, can you please teach psychrometry? Yes, aap ke liye kuch bhi karenge. Don't worry. Dekho ek baar. Wet bulb temperature ka significance kya hai? Wet bulb temperature kya show karta hai? Air mein moisture content ka. Agar air mein moisture zyada hai, तो ड्राई बल्ब वेट बल्ब का डिफरेंस कम होगा क्योंकि अगर एयर में मॉइस्चर ज्यादा है तो वो सैचुरेशन रीच होने के लिए बहुत कम मॉइस्चर चाहिए तो टू नीड लिटिल मॉइस्चर इट हैज टू लिटिल हीट व्हेन इट इज लूजिंग लिटिल हीट द डिफरेंस विल बी वेरी वेरी स्मॉल ओके राइट नाउ वन ऑफ माय स्टूडेंट्स सेड टेक वन सब्जेक्ट फ्री ऑन दिस ओके डेफिनेटली मैं ऐसा शेड्यूल प्लान करता हूं सो आई विल प्लान सूटेबली देखो एक सेकंड देखो ध्यान से सुनो दिस ह्यूमिडिटी इज एक क्रूड लैंग्वेज में बात करेंगे क्रूड लैंग्वेज में व्हाट डू मीन बाय क्रूड लैंग्वेज लेमैन लैंग्वेज नॉट इट इज नथिंग बट वाटर वेपर व्हिच इज प्रेजेंट इन एयर ह्यूमिडिटी इज व्हाट वाटर वेपर व्हिच इज प्रेजेंट इन एयर अब देखते हैं इसका इन्फ्लुएंस क्यों पड़ना है ह्यूमिडिटी अगर ह्यूमिडिटी ज्यादा है ध्यान से सुनो एयर में ह्यूमिडिटी बहुत ज्यादा है In air, humidity is very high. तो क्या होगा देखो You are running. Morning jogging किए Sweat आ गया देखो यहां पे sweat आ गया Already air में water vapor क्या है ज्यादा है Means humidity is high. अगर humidity is very very high, तो आपका humidity, आपका moisture क्यों care करेगा वो I repeat, if the humidity in air is very very high, I'm talking about the influence of humidity on our comfort. अगर air में humidity ज्यादा है अरे यार आपके पास बहुत पैसा है तो आप केयर नहीं करेंगे किसी के लिए यू डोंट सो सिमिलरली इफ द ह्यूमिडिटी इन एयर इज वेरी हाई इट विल नॉट केयर योर मॉइस्चर अब मॉर्निंग जॉगिंग करके आ गए तो मॉइस्चर हाथ पे है मॉइस्चर स्वेट तो एक्चुअली एयर शुड पिक अप दैट स्वेट लेकिन उसके पास ऑलरेडी ज्यादा है तो आपके स्वेट को केयर ही नहीं करा जब केयर नहीं करा दैट स्वेट विल बी देयर ऑन योर हैंड ओनली सो स्टिकी यू आर नॉट कंफर्टेबल सो व्हेन द ह्यूमिडिटी इज हाई यू आर नॉट कंफर्टेबल अगर ह्यूमिडिटी बहुत कम है देखेंगे क्या होगा मान लो एयर में ह्यूमिडिटी बहुत कम है अब वो तरसता है बहुत कम है अगर कम है तो इट विल ट्राई टू एब्जॉर्ब तो क्या करेगा इवन अगर आप स्वेट नहीं करेंगे ना स्किन के नीचे का जो मॉइस्चर है वो ले लेगा एयर लेगा क्यों लेगा बिकॉज इट हैज लेस ह्यूमिडिटी तो इसलिए वो ले रहा है जब लेगा सो स्किन के नीचे का मॉइस्चर पूरा कम हो जाएगा पूरा स्किन ड्राई होगा ये सब विंटर में होगा हम आपको ब्यूटीफुली बताएंगे विंटर एयर कंडीशनिंग में तो विंटर में एयर में मॉइस्चर कंटेंट क्या होता है बहुत कम होता है जब कम होता है क्यों कम होता है देखो ध्यान से सुनो सो समर में जब टेम्परेचर ज्यादा होता है तो वेपर इवेपोरेशन फास्ट होता है जब टेम्परेचर के कारण एट हाई टेम्परेचर द मॉलिक्यूलर एक्टिविटी हाई तो इवेपोरेशन इज फास्ट व्हेन इवेपोरेशन इज फास्ट मॉइस्चर कंटेंट इन एयर इज लेस एट लो टेम्परेचर्स मॉलिक्यूलर एक्टिविटी इज लेस द इन विंटर द टेम्परेचर्स आर लो जब टेम्परेचर्स कम है इवेपोरेशन इज लेस तो एयर में ह्यूमिडिटी कम होगा जब एयर में ह्यूमिडिटी कम होगा वो आपके स्किन के नीचे का मॉइस्चर भी एब्जॉर्ब करेगा जब पूरा एब्जॉर्ब करेगा पूरा ड्राई हो जाएगा व्हाइट पैचेस तब क्या करेंगे आप मॉइस्चराइजर पॉन्ड्स कोल्ड क्रीम अप्लाई करेंगे आर्टिफिशियल तो इसलिए ह्यूमिडिटी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट रोल प्ले करता है. ह्यूमिडिटी हैज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल एंड आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑल दिस ब्यूटीफुली इन माय नेक्स्ट स्पेशल क्लास फ्रीली. बट अगर आप development of psychrometric chart miss karenge, definitely you'll be missing something. And I'll focus again on relative humidity, degree of saturation, enthalpy. So enthalpy ka significance ye sara batayenge. All of you, have you followed? So time up bol raha hai. So all of you, have you followed? Love you all. Are yaar, aap to ek second mein 125 yes bolte hai. So pranam sabko, very very happy. So mera full course fluid mechanics ka 23rd October se aa raha hai in gate. And daily my class will be from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. It's a full. It's a full FM class. It's a full FM class. Fluid mechanics. And I'll tell you one thing. I will be covering both from GATE and IES point of view. Sare detailed way mein, around 400 numericals, all physical explanations. That's why I'm taking 44 sessions. It's come at the 44 into 2, 88 hours for fluid mechanics. So please, sir, in the next class, I'll continue with the psychrometry and development of psychrometric chart. Uska shape aisa hi kyun hai? Aisa hi kyun aa raha? Aur enthalpy ka line aisa hi kyun hai? और रिलेटिव ह्यूमिडिटी का ऐसा ही क्यों है कि सारे मैं बताऊंगा आपको. आई टेल यू व्हाई इट इज कमिंग एंड सिग्निफिकेंस. सो लाइक थैंक यू ऑल. सो यू कैन यूज माय रेफरल कोड PK006 फॉर 006 प्रवीण कुलकर्णी 006 फॉर अवेलिंग डिस्काउंट. सो आई विल बी अवेलेबल. मतलब डेफिनेटली माय साइक्रोमेट्री. सम स्टूडेंट्स रिक्वेस्टेड मी, नो आई विल बी टीचिंग FM, strength of materials, thermo, heat transfer, gajab, don't worry. Then machine design, RAC, power plant engineering, complete from ESC point of view, power plant engineering. Then we have IC engines, all your turbo machinery, fluid machinery, turbo machinery, all these I'll be teaching. So first I'm starting on 23rd October, 8 to 10. Fluid mechanics, and it's my promise. I'll try my level best to show the beauty of this subject. Okay, thank you all. So I wish you all the best. So please do well. So this is Kulkarni Praveen signing off. Thank you. God bless you. Good night. So next class, it will be continuation of the psychrometry special class, free class. So thank you all. So the response which I am seeing from you, matlab in a very limited 2 to 3 classes, such a thousands of views, I'm really thankful to you. Good night and all the best. God bless you. Bye bye. Chalo aaj ke liye itna hi. Enjoy karo. Aur ek baat, one more thing, please aapke comments or messages, if you love the class, please don't forget 78931909097. Please, it motivates us. So zarur is number pe, this is on WhatsApp as well as normal message, jo bhi hai, 78931909097 karna hi hai, nahi to aapko next class nahi karne denge. Sorry. Goodbye. Bye bye. Okay, this is Kulkarni signing off. Goodbye. Good night. It's a wonderful.